Hello friends, today we'll discuss about the magnetic materials. So initially we'll discuss about the fundamental concept, or we can say that the basic concept. So we know that magnetic substances are different from one another in their behavior in the magnetic field. So according to their magnetic properties, they are classified into three principal groups. First one is the diamagnetic, second one is the paramagnetic, and third one is the ferromagnetic. So the intensity of the magnetization M is used to characterize the magnetization of the substances. If there is a large class of magnetic materials, it is found that the intensity of magnetization M is directly proportional to the magnetic field intensity. Here we can see that M is nothing but the magnetization and H is nothing but the magnetic field intensity. So mathematically we can write M is proportional to the H. So then we can write the equation M is equal to psi into H. So psi is nothing but the magnetic susceptibility. So magnetic susceptibility indicated by the symbol psi. Now we'll discuss about the types of the magnetic materials. Materials which can be magnetized by the application of the external magnetic field is called as a magnetic materials. Means materials which can be magnetized by the external magnetic field, that material is nothing but the magnetic materials. Now based on the permanent magnetic dipole of the atoms, they are classified as diamagnetic, paramagnetic, ferromagnetic, antiferromagnetic and ferrimagnetic. So first we'll discuss about the diamagnetic material. So this type of the materials do not have the permanent magnetic dipoles. Means now here we can see that when we apply the magnetic field and without applied magnetic field. So when a diamagnetic material is placed in an external magnetic field, then they produce or induce the magnetic dipoles and which acts in an opposite direction to the applied field. Means when we apply the external magnetic field, then magnetic dipoles induced inside the material having direction is opposite to the direction of the magnetic field. The substances whose outermost orbit have an even number of electrons show the property of the diamagnetism. Now one more property is there, they are weakly attracted by the magnetic. Again, they have small and negative susceptibility. Susceptibility of the diamagnetic material is very, very small and negative. And they have the examples copper, gold, water, etc. Now, second type of the magnetic material is paramagnetic material. So they possess permanent magnetic dipole. Now, permanent magnetic dipole means what? When we apply the external field, having direction is opposite to the applied field, and when we remove the magnetic field, the magnetization still remain in a material that is nothing but the permanent magnetic dipole. So paramagnetic materials have permanent magnetic dipoles. Again, second property is the dipoles are randomly oriented. Now in case of paramagnetic materials, dipoles are randomly oriented, and therefore what happens, the net magnetization is zero. So when they placed in an external magnetic field, or we can say that when we apply the external magnetic field, these materials acquire weak magnetism in the direction of the applied field. Means when we apply the magnetic field, then the induced dipoles are tried to align with the direction of the external magnetic field. So they have small and positive susceptibility but less than one. And examples, aluminium, platinum, manganese, etc. Now third type of the magnetic material is ferromagnetic materials. Now these materials exhibit high degree of magnetization. Means when we apply a small external field, these ferromagnetic materials produce large value of or large amount of magnetization, and hence we can see that these materials exhibit high degree of magnetization. So when they placed in an external magnetic field, they acquire strong magnetism in the direction of an applied field. So here also, this in ferromagnetic materials, inducer dipoles are tried to align with the direction of the external field. So they are strongly attracted by the magnet. They are large and positive susceptibility. Means in ferromagnetic materials, susceptibility is positive and very very large. And example of the ferromagnetic materials are iron, nickel, cobalt, etc. Now next type of the magnetic material is antiferromagnetic materials. Now these materials possess dipole moment due to spin of electron. Now here in this type of material, the dipoles are produced, that dipoles are because of spin of electrons. So electron spins, atoms are aligned anti-parallel, means the dipoles are aligned anti-parallel in the material. So in these materials, the interacting atoms are very close to each other and exchange forces produce a tendency for anti-parallel alignment of electron spins of neighboring atom. Means that anti-parallel alignment in anti-ferromagnetic material is due to the interaction of the dipoles. Okay, the resultant magnetic effect for the material is therefore zero. And they have, next one more property of antiferromagnetic material is there, they have small and positive susceptibility. Now examples, chromium, copper, chloride, manganese oxide, etc. Now in varying temperature, they can be seen to exhibit diamagnetic and ferromagnetic property. In case of antiferromagnetic substances, the momentum are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. As a result, the net magnetization is zero. Now last type of magnetic material is ferrimagnetic material. Now what happen in ferrimagnetic material? These ferrimagnetic materials are similar to the antiferromagnetic material. Means like antiferromagnetic material, the alignment of the dipoles are anti-parallel. But magnitude of that dipoles are not same. What happen in case of antiferromagnetic material? Dipole alignment is anti-parallel with equal magnitude. But what happen in ferrimagnetic material? The dipole alignment is anti-parallel, but magnitudes of all the dipoles are not equal. Now the magnetic moment of the materials oriented in one direction is greater than those oriented in opposite direction. That is, spin alignment is anti-parallel of different magnitudes. As a result, there is a net magnetization in the material. Now we'll discuss about ferrite. Ferrites are the materials which possess magnetic dipole moment due to the spin of electrons, and also the adjacent ones are aligned in anti-parallel direction. But the magnetic moment of those oriented in one direction is greater than those oriented in opposite direction. That is, spin alignment is anti-parallel of different magnitudes as shown in following figure. As a result, there is a net magnetization of the material. Means what happened in ferrite, the direction of the dipoles are anti-parallel with unequal magnitude. Now there are some properties of the ferrite. First one is the spin alignment is anti-parallel with unequal magnitude. Second property of the ferrite is ferrite possesses net magnetic moment. Now next property, ferrites fall under a general formula, or we can say that simply the ferrite having the formula Mfe2O4, where M represent the divalent ion. Next property, magnetization of the ferrite can be controlled by changing their composition. Now next one, above Curie temperature they becomes paramagnetic. Now next, they are electrically insulators, but they possess the magnetic properties. Now like properties, ferrites have some applications. Now, first application, ferrites are of great interest from electrical engineering point of view. They behave as a ferromagnetic materials below a certain temperature. Second one, because of low eddy current and hysteresis losses, the ferrites are used in microwave devices. Third one, hard ferrites are used for constructing permanent magnet. Next application of ferrite is, soft ferrites are used in production of cores for inductor coils used in telecommunication. Now next application is, it is used to produce ultrasonic waves because it exhibit magnetostriction effect. Now after that we'll discuss about the garnet. Now garnets is similar like to the ferrites. So garnets are group of silicate minerals. All species of garnet possess similar physical properties and crystal forms but differ in chemical composition. Garnet species found in many colors including red, orange, yellow, green, purple, brown, black, blue, pink, or also colorless with reddish shades most commonly. Now after that we'll discuss about the BH curve. Now B indicates magnetization and H indicates the magnetizing field. So we'll discuss about the BH curve briefly. Consider an unmagnetized bar of ferromagnetic substance. This bar is placed in an external magnetic field. Or simply we can say that, consider a ferromagnetic materials which is placed in an external magnetic field. To start with, gradually increase the magnetizing field H, which is indicated by the symbol H, and find the corresponding value of magnetic induction B. Before some time I have told B is indicated magnetic field. So instead of that magnetic field, B indicates the magnetizing induction, or we can say that the magnetic field. Magnetic induction, or we can say that the flux density. Okay. So initially we increase the magnetizing field H and see what happens. Now here a graph of B versus H gives the hysteresis loop as shown in this following figure. Now H indicates the magnetizing field and B indicates the magnetic induction, or we can say that the flux density. If we increase the magnetizing field, the point C remains constant and the substance said to be a saturated. Means if we increase the magnetizing field, here we can see that, then we get the point C, and that point C is nothing but the saturation point. Means at that point the magnetic induction is higher, and hence we can say that the saturated point or saturation point. Now after reaching the point C, gradually decreases the H and obtain the value of B. It is found that the curve takes the form CD. Okay. Now after that, the magnetizing field is gradually decreases. Okay. Instead of this path, the path follow like CD. Okay. Thus, when H is zero, the intensity of magnetization instead of being zero has a value is equal to OD. This value